assertion and reason. Statement 1. A block of mass M1 is kept against a smooth vertical wall. Another block of mass M2 is kept over M1. And a horizontal force F is applied on M2. There is no friction between any surface except M1 and M2. Friction force between M1 and M2 is 0. So first we need to check the friction force between M1 and M2. So we'll draw the figure and check. And we have to verify statement 1 is true, statement 2 is true, and then whether statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1 or not. So let us see. First, we'll draw the figure as told to us or is given in the question. Block of mass M1 is kept against a smooth vertical wall. So we'll take a vertical wall. We'll keep a block M1. Another block of mass M2 is kept over M1. That we will keep it. A horizontal force will apply. And friction force is there only between M1 and M2. And that friction force we have to prove it equal to 0. So let us see which or what is given to us. Let us take this is the vertical wall. Now to this vertical wall, there is a mass attached here. This mass is M1. Over this, another body is attached. This mass is equal to M2. There is a force horizontal applied on the block. This force is capital F. Now friction is existing between only M1 and M2. So let me draw the free body diagram of M1 and M2. So if we take M1 body here and M2, one by one, we'll draw the free body diagram. Horizontal force is exerted on M2 and that force is F. Because of this force, this body is going to apply a force on this. This is the contact force between them. Let me call N1. So here, there will be a contact force from M1 to M2. That will be N1. This body will apply a force on the vertical wall, that is N2. So vertical wall also gives a normal reaction called N2. Now from the figure, N1 is nothing but F. So N1 will be equal to F. Now here, if this is F, N2 also will be equal to F. This body is pulled down because there is an acceleration due to gravity. So mg will be acting here. This body is also pulled down because there is a force acting mg in the normal direction. So what will be the friction force over here? Friction force will be equal to 0. Between this, friction force will be equal to 0. Because both are being pulled down with acceleration due to gravity in the downward direction. And these horizontal forces are balanced. So friction force will be mu times of n. And n is nothing but f. Here also mu times of n. Here also n is nothing but f. So friction force is 0. So the first statement is true. So here we will take the first statement is true. Let us see the second statement. Friction force acting on the body is always opposite to the direction of motion of the body. So here we will take this is the horizontal surface. On this we will take one body, we will take the another body. Suppose a horizontal force F is applied on the above body. The acceleration is in this direction. So motion of the body is in this direction. So friction force will exist between the two surfaces. So if I take this body as M1 and M2 and draw the free body diagram for M1 and M2, for M2, this force is applied as called capital F. Friction force will be existing here. This is the small f. Now on M1, both bodies are going to move in this direction with an acceleration A. So if on M1 we draw the free body diagram, this is F. If here the surface is smooth, no force is acting. So here the friction force is in the direction of the motion of the body. So what it is said in the second statement is friction force will be always in the opposite direction to the motion of body. That statement will go wrong. So friction force acting on the body is always opposite to the direction of motion of the body. But in this case, if we check it, the friction force is in the direction of motion of the body. Here, friction is in the direction of motion of the body. So second statement is wrong. So second statement is false. So what will be the correct option here? Now these two, statement 1 and 2 are true, is ruled out. B also is ruled out because both statement 1 and 2 are true here. Statement 1 is true, 2 is false. So option C will be the correct option. And in the D option, statement 1 is false, statement 2 is true, is also wrong option. So option C will be the correct option. So answer for this particular question will be option C.